What's this story about? This story is about a small, quiet little town in the panhandle of Texas that got sick and tired of the dope dealers, and they hired me and I stood up for them.
This is a story about a town that wanted to send a message to the black community.
I think the story is simply about a community doing its best to do what they believe is right.
This young man was stolen from his family and stolen from his community.
This is a story about how our idea of justice gets corrupted when we declare war on something.
One of my friends called me and said, hey, they're supposed to be having a lot of trouble with narcotics in a little town around Amarillo somewhere. So I said, okay. So I got on the telephone and I made a few phone calls and found out it was Tulia.
We'd set up the arrest to take place early morning hours. Just about daylight.
We assembled at the fire station and had arrest warrants. The police department, the sheriff's department, the Texas Rangers, the narcotics task force, and we did a roundup. It felt good. It was time to make our mark.
I had just woke up. I was the first one to wake up in our house.
And we looked out the window and we seen like our house was surrounded by cops, and the undercover cop had a ski mask on and he pulls it off and he's like, do you remember me? And Freddie said, no, I don't know you.
When I grabbed an indictment, I was looking at it and I seen delivery of cocaine. I was like, I just looked at him. I was like, nah, man, I think y'all had the wrong house. So I slid it back out to him and was gonna close the door. And they were like, if you close the door, we're gonna be forced to shoot.
It happened so fast, and the thing I kept thinking was, I'm glad my daughter's not here to see this.
I couldn't believe it. It was a shock to me. I'm 48 years old. I've never been arrested, knock on wood. Haven't had family members arrested and went through this type of ordeal.